Oldenakey here with another Destiny video, and this is the Daily Heroic story for today, October 12th, 2016. And it is the Black Garden, the last of the Year One stories. And this is a bit of a pain in the butt. It's probably the longest story in Year One. And running it at level 350, one has to be a little careful about taking fire from multiple angles.
I don't think we'll get a second chance at this. We pull this off, we can save the Traveler. If not...
But it definitely is doable, even solo. Now I'm running my Titan Sunbreaker. My Hung Jury Scout Rifle, my Devil's Dawn Sniper, and my shiny new Gjallarhorn, which I still really need to level up.
Let's head for the gate.
Alright, off we go. Seems to me that many of these on-world stories, we've got a lot of traveling to do via Sparrow to get to where we want to go. Oh, just sit back and drive. Now this is all public area, even when we get to the gate. So it's possible... Whoops! Drove into that rock. It's possible that some of the bad guys guarding the gate will be taken care of. In this particular run, I had to start taking them out, and then somebody else showed up. Took out the Hydra, I believe. Help with the last Minotaur. But we're going to have several Minotaurs, a Hydra, and maybe a couple of Hobgoblins here. There's the Hydra and one of the Minotaurs. Now they're not yellow bars, so we can take them out with a sniper, a couple of shots. One shot and several from my scout rifle. Running around the other side here. Okay, somebody else showed up. And like I said, he took out the Hydra. Looks like he's gonna take out that Hobgoblin too. Thanks, pal, appreciate it. You must be running the story as well.
I hope this works.
I'm just kind of bobbing and weaving here, picking up drops. Ammo.
Where are we?
I don't know what he's doing.
If this is the Black Garden, it's not on any map of known space and time. I guess we just keep going?
Yep, we just keep going.
We're in some kind of stasis.
Alright, right about here is where they start to wake up. And we just gotta fight our way through these guys and more bad guys. We get to the Black Garden itself. Now, Hung Jury, both my Hung Jury and my Devil's Dawn have Firefly enabled. I'm a little concerned because earlier today I was running patrol and I took out a knight at close quarters with a headshot. Which enabled, you know, which you blew up because of Firefly, and then my game just hung up on me. Screeching audio and a frozen game, and I had to ultimately blew me back to the start screen. So I'm always a little concerned about Firefly, but I think it's taking somebody out at close range. That's probably the remaining bug they haven't fixed. Alright, anyway, we just need to take these guys out. Now my artifact is the one that turns a bad guy into an ally when you melee him, so I'm just going to sit back and enjoy this. one thing one has to be careful about is that there is a time limit on this. And he will eventually turn back into a bad guy. I did take out that that harpy. Now here's where he turns back into a bad guy, and I totally forgot about it. He's gonna come up behind me right there. Whoops. He almost took me out. Not a good thing, because I like to run these little walkthrough missions with no deaths. And this particular story is a tough one to do with no deaths. Hobgoblins. This probably should be your first order of business. Then Minotaurs, because they're off distance. Now, if I can get the goblins close together, I can take two of them out with one shot, headshot, which is actually a belly shot. But those guys, okay, where is he? There he is. Takes two shots to the gut for a hobgoblin with the scout rifle. One shot with my sniper. All right, running around looking for ammo. Never hurts to do that. I'm not in any hurry. I'm not speed running this thing. In fact, I wouldn't know how to speed run it. Alright, here we go. Now, I'm going to take a little shortcut here, but if you can't do the jump, you can run straight and around the corner and get to about in the vicinity of where I'm going to be. Tactics change a little bit, but this is an easier way to do it. I got more cover. Notice I got two hobgoblins up on that ledge up there, way off in the distance. What I'm looking for now. Right there. One. The other one got damaged. From the, I probably should have done a clip of that one. But that's okay. Alright, we got some goblins down here at the bottom. I'm going to clean those up. We're going to have a Hydra and a Minotaur and some more goblins spawn back off to the right here. That's the Hydra, that's the not the Undying Mind thingy, or whatever it's called. Alright, several snipes in the eye and several more scout rifle bursts, and that takes care of the super duper Hydra. Then we got some goblins and the Minotaur. Alright. Gather some goodies up. Get a little bit more dropping up here with the hobgoblins. Anyway, on to the next encounter. It's another Hydra. A yellow bar Hydra. Something or other. Alright. What? Just died. Alright. Snipe the hobgoblin. Bring these guys up. There might be one more hobgoblin off to the left. He's up there on that upper ledge. Grenades. Alright. Goblins out of here so I can take out the hobgoblin. is. Alright. Oops. Oh, they just keep showing up. Alright. I think that is it. Ooh, heavy. And more heavy. Good. I'm resisting the use of my Galahorn to the three boss fight at the end. I'm trying not to burn synth. Okay, now you know, I always miss that. I always run straight ahead when I should be making a left turn here. Bad we didn't have a take out 50 goblins bounty today. Or goblin majors, I mean, or 50 vex, I should say. Vex majors. Alright, that takes care of that one. There's another one down here. And what I've noticed here with the shields is you put one shot on the hobgoblin and he'll go to his shields. And then when he pops back up, he's easy prey. Alright, let's get that Minotaur. It's not too difficult. I probably could have kept on using my... Ooh, didn't want to fall off the ledge there. I could have probably, I could have kept on using my, scout rifle, but that's okay. Alright, here we go. I'm not sure what I was doing there. Might have been a phone call or something. Alright, we're gonna have to take out... Well, we're not quite there yet. Few more goblins and hobgoblins and whatever adds, I guess, to take out before we get to the close to the gate. Alright, that takes care of that. Now, there's the gate off there in the distance.
Dead end. The heart is just beyond here.
We got two spots that we have to clear.
This place clear is just one big machine.
Scan.
Get me close to the clusters.
And you can see the waypoints up to the right and off to the left. I prefer to start with the right side just because I'm used to doing it that way. I'm taking fire from harpies here on the left. I can always step back enough so that they can't see me. It doesn't hurt to clear a few of them out, because when we get done with the right side, we're going to have to deal with them on the left. Now we're going to have a bunch of goblins and hobgoblins, and protected by a yellow bar minotaur up there at the top. And both sides are essentially the same that way, although we have more harpies on the left side than goblins, and there's no real harpies on the right, but there are goblins and hobgoblins. Oh, shoot, he's pretty accurate. I'm not getting much damage on this guy. So, I'm gonna hide. Well, I hit him that time. Whoa! I must have just That's the thing. You get the you get damaged. Get them damaged enough, and that's with all the Vex. They'll charge you. Or take their heads off, and they charge. Didn't realize I had one like that. Gotta be a little bit careful. Okay. Harpies from the left side. Yeah, go high, you knucklehead. I get you. Alright. Put a little more damage on. Like I said, I am saving my Galahorn for the big triple boss. Taking the shields down 2/3 and then throwing a grenade at him will take out the yellow bar Minotaur. And also guarantee that he will charge at you. Okay, we got any more up here? I think that was it for this side. Let's see. Just running around looking for ammo. Alright, so we got to scan this thingy here. I guess what we're doing is we're creating a spire. And we need to scan this.
Just need to break their medical
thing here, and the one on the left where the left waypoint is.
Let's hit the other one. It's working. The
spire is forming. Okay. So now we got to go down here to the left. You just barely see the spire on the screen. And the left is most, like I said, is mostly harpies, and we've taken most of them out. Maybe a goblin or two. And the big bad yellow bar Minotaur. And I'm going to try to use the same approach with him. Get him down a pretty good ways. Take his head off. He's going to come charging. Kind of close to that grenade. Yeah, make sure you have plenty enough room to jump back. I didn't. I jumped right to a post. Alright, now we scan the second thingy here. Whatever it is. It looks like a portal.
It's all starting to make sense. Let's see if it works.
Alright, so the spire's formed. It's completing its formation here. You can hear a special rumbling stomach sound when it's formed. Alright, just gotta clear out some effects here. They're mostly adds, goblins and hobgoblins. And then we can step into the circle. Scan one more time, and this will get us the key that we can open the gate with the Black Guard.
All we need is permission to enter as a gate lord.
Alright, I'm going to pop a 3 of coins here. I actually used 3 of them in this run. These guys will drop exotics. Didn't happen for me, but if you got 3 of coins, use them. And there are 3 ultras in here. One of today's bounties is taken.
Well, there goes nothing.
Or I might have just had that left over. I took care of that earlier. That did not come. All right, I'm going to just take a quick look here at the nastiness there, and go ahead and skip the cutscene. This is a bunch of blah blah blah. All right, now a lot of people tend to want to stay up here, but the approach that I use is I come down here, go all the way to the left, and start taking out these goblins. They're all goblins. Be a little bit careful because we're at level 350 and there are a lot more in this than a regular story. So, what I do is take a few out, and I'll get a little health from that guy. Take a few out and just run around. You always want to be a moving target. Take a few more out, run around a little bit more. Here's my buddy helping me out. Find cover whenever you can. I think the fact that my melee buddy is firing at him has got him slightly distracted off of me. And of course Firefly helps. His timer ran out and he came after me. But he's pretty easy to take out. Simple melee to take him out. Alright. So, you know, take a few out, run around, take a few more out, run around, one or two more left. Alright, once we take out this all the goblins, then the statues will come to life one at a time. Going from the far side, the one I'm running for now. Yep, you hear the music changing, that means we're ready. Alright, so... there'll be three ways
to bring that statue to life.
One for each statue. And there will be ads. The first set of ads, I believe, are goblins. The second set of ads are harpies. And the third set of minotaurs. Each one gets a little tougher. A couple of Calamorn blasts on this guy. And start running again. Ads, so you don't take too much fire. This is in the back of these structures you're heading. Oh, more harpies. Oh, okay. Goblins and harpies are in the first wave. Hobgoblins are in the second wave. They're a little bit tougher to deal with. And of course, the minotaurs in the third wave. Alright. That's a good spot. Notice I'm knocking him back a little bit with these shots. Alright, just about got him down. They took care of him. Now when he goes down, all the ads will despawn.
Heart is dying.
I can't believe I got a green drop from an ultra like that. Boss. Okay. Oh good, more heavy. Alright, now the second one is right where I'm at, so I'm going to run back to the other side here. See if he's starting to warm. Third one, the guy in the middle, he's the tougher one. Alright, pop another three of coins. Now, don't start shooting until you see the yellow bar completely moving. Alright, let's go running. Yep, get rid of these hobgoblins. Goblins and hobgoblins. Okay. One of these days I'll get using one punch straight. Ah, there we go. Hobgoblins. Clean them out a little bit. So I get room and maneuver. Back around. This Neckman with a nice shiny belly button. Start taking fire, run to the other side. Last thing in the world you want to do is stay stationary. Alright, let's see if we can take him out. There we go. That'll despawn all the ads. Of course, I did not get a drop that time either, so that's disappointing. Alright, here we go, the last one. Big tough guy. And I got plenty of rocks. Reload. out of their way. I think that one actually took them out. Yep. I didn't know that at the time. I'm gonna run out here and drill him with my super. You can see the motion detector go blank. That was the Minotaur in the spawn. But that's it. A little long. 25 minutes or so.
We're back on Mars.
Some actual gameplay.
The shroud of darkness is lifted, and light returns to the traveler.
All right, I'm just running around here looking for
the speaker is calling us home.
Ammo. Now I got 14 here because I had 186 to start, so I hit my 200 cap. But if you're under the cap, under 185 or less, you'll get the full 15. So that's it. As we go back to orbit here, I do hope this helps you in your quest for today's Daily Heroic story. The Black Garden, this is Olden Akey signing off. Take care, everybody.